Hello, and welcome to the Licensing Expert Series on Licensing Office 2013 and Office 365. My name is Bob Mixa. Let's begin by reviewing today's agenda. First, we'll look at trends that are impacting the way we work and what is essential for businesses and consumers with regard to productivity. Then, we will look at features and benefits of the new Office and how Microsoft is helping customers make the transition to the cloud with offers that are economically attractive and simple to manage through Office 365. We will then take a look at the new suites and servers, client access licenses, and then we will review migrations to the new software for those customers with software assurance. We'll then take a detailed look at two attractive ways for enterprise agreement customers to acquire Office 365 services while maintaining the integrity of their existing agreement. Several customer scenarios will follow, after which you will have the opportunity to take an assessment. Multiple factors impact the way we work, but three major trends are impacting the way we work and how we interact. The first is the proliferation of devices. Researchers forecasted that by 2016, there would be a total of 1 billion smartphone customers. By 2012, these forecasts were exceeded and there were 1.2 billion smartphones bought. The pace is accelerating, and the way we use these devices has changed. With smartphones, real-time access to email and social media notifications, we are always connected, and organizations need to ensure information is kept safe. The second trend is related to people and the way people get things done. Multiple generations are in the workforce and have different expectations of work and life, like being able to work remotely with a flexible schedule, and businesses need to provide the right communication and collaboration tools to bring these people together. Third is the transformational trend of cloud computing, which changes the way we deliver and consume software and applications. According to a recent research from IDC, spend in cloud services and enablement will hit $60 billion by 2020, and over 50% of customers on the road to the cloud. Most businesses today are looking at a hybrid approach to adopting the cloud, with a mix of on-premises solutions and multiple cloud offerings. In today's world, people need to be able to work from anywhere, collaborate easily, and provide high-quality professional deliverables with reliability and in a secure, affordable technology. Anywhere access capabilities provide users with Office applications across multiple devices, from PCs to smartphones to tablets. And working together is easier and more effective no matter where teams are located, with video conferencing, shared documents, email and calendar, with enhanced multimedia and graphics capabilities, all backed by the security and reliability of Microsoft. With Office 2013 and Office 365 provides the tools for businesses that meet the demands for today's worker. It's important to think about Office in a different light now, as it now encompasses both cloud and services and the on-premises perpetual product. So, in the cloud, Office is available as Office 365, which is a subscription program that provides customers with access to Office applications and additional cloud services like business-grade email, shared calendar, internal and external sites, and video conferencing. Office 365 gives customers virtually anywhere access to the Microsoft Office tools that they know and rely on. Plus, it provides them with business-class IT services that are easy to administer. For the traditional on-premises Office product, customers receive perpetual use rights to Office purchased through traditional channels, full package product, or FPP, OEM, which is original equipment manufacturer, and through Microsoft volume licensing programs. Either way, Microsoft provides customers with the flexibility to choose the delivery of Office that best fits their organization's size and particular needs. In today's world, people need to be able to work from anywhere, collaborate easily, and provide high-quality professional deliverables with reliability and in a secure, affordable technology. Office 2013 provides the tools for business that meet the demands of today's mobile worker. Anywhere access capabilities provide users with Office applications across multiple devices, from PCs to smartphones to tablets. And working together is easier and more effective no matter where teams are located, with video conferencing, shared documents, email, and calendar, with enhanced multimedia and graphic capabilities, all backed by the security and reliability of Microsoft. Office 2013 provides a fast and fluid user experience with either touchscreen technology with pen, using mouse, or with a keyboard, with access to Windows 8 apps and tools that are optimized for the cloud with multi-party HD video and Skype federation. On-premises Office 2013 suites continue to be available through the traditional retail channels and through Microsoft volume licensing with Office Standard 2013 and Office Professional Plus 2013 being the business-optimized suites available. Office 365 online subscription service provides email, shared calendar, the ability to create and edit documents online, and instant messaging, web conferencing, a public website, and internal team sites, all accessible anywhere from nearly any device. And since this is a subscription offering, there are unlimited automatic product updates without any upfront infrastructure costs, making the monthly subscription offer an unbeatable value. Let's take a closer look. With Office 365, you have a secure anywhere access to world-class tools in a scalable per-user licensing model, ideal for today's mobile worker using multiple devices. Deployment concerns are alleviated as the services are hosted by Microsoft and delivered where and when customers need them using Link Online, SharePoint Online, and Exchange Online. And customers with Office 2010 installed on their computers can quickly configure their software to work with Office 365. Office 365 is also compatible with Office 2007 and newer editions of Office, and select Office 365 plans include Office Professional Plus. Office 365 Enterprise plans, or E-plans, provides the greatest flexibility and control for enterprise customers' sophisticated IT needs. With features such as archiving and legal hold and the newly added rights management, enterprises can easily be configured to accommodate a range of needs across users and in hybrid deployments. Enterprise is ideal for organizations with over 250 users and provides an advanced admin portal with Active Directory, push deployment of the Office client, and business intelligence and roaming and mobile access on up to 5 devices. With Office 365, Enterprise suites offer a great value with Office web apps and new features across Exchange, SharePoint, and Link. K1 is for the kiosk workers, who are basically deskless workers. And please do note that there are not any transitions to K1, which is a limited offer. Now, E1 offers Office web apps and 50 gigabytes for email and calendar. You'll notice that E4 is, of course, the premium offer with full enterprise voice. Note also that Office Pro Plus is available in both E3 and E4. Anyone familiar with enterprise suites will notice that E2 and K2 are no longer available for new orders, but all the capabilities of K2 and E2 are now available in K1 and E1 respectively. Microsoft provides a targeted offer for mid-sized businesses with 10 to 250 users that offer click-to-run deployment of Office, 20 internal SharePoint sites, Active Directory, and virtual meetings. The mid-size offer is available in open through syndication partners, through a customer's partner of record or software advisor, and through Microsoft Online Services Agreement. Enterprise E3 offers a more advanced admin console and the highest level of support with push deployment, archiving, legal hold, data loss prevention, as well as Excel, Access, Visio services, and voicemail and rights management. The Enterprise E3 offer is available with an enterprise agreement through syndication partners, through a customer's partner of record, or through a Microsoft online services agreement. When comparing the features and functionalities of the Office suites available through Microsoft Volume Licensing and Office 365, Office 365 Pro Plus provides the best value and the best client experience. With Office 365 Pro Plus, subscribers receive click-to-run deployment of Office using AppV technology to stream software directly to users' PCs, and they receive automatic version upgrades, roaming apps, the ability to access Office on additional devices, and save-to-the-cloud capabilities, enabling customers to carry their documents with them. There are two key changes to note with Office 2013 suites. Business Contact Manager for Outlook is discontinued since it's now available as a free download, and SharePoint Workspace is discontinued. SkyDrive Pro, its successor, is available in its place to customers licensed for Office at no charge. Customers with Office Pro Plus 2010 with SA and Office Standard 2010 with SA receive rights to the new Office 2013 of the corresponding edition. Standalone online services can be obtained individually for Exchange, SharePoint, Link, and Office with new capabilities or features shown here in green. These include unlimited storage, data loss prevention, encryption, site mailboxes, and Exchange online protection. For SharePoint, the new features available with the standalone plans include drag-and-drop site mailboxes, eDiscovery, compliance, and Power View. For Office standalone plans, we've added fast search, drag-and-drop, and site mailboxes with Office web apps and shared online, and Mac compatibility and roaming and mobile rights are new features available with Office 365 Pro Plus standalone offer. Microsoft has also added new user-based services for Visio, our diagramming software, and Project for project management. These services run on a user's licensed PC with click-to-run technology for quick and easy download, saving customers from having to deploy on-premises servers. Here we see the availability of Office Standard, Office Professional Plus, and Office 365 Pro Plus in a number of channels. Open, Select, EA, Advisor or Partner of Record, MOSA, or through syndication partners. EA customers can transition anytime during the agreement to Office 365 Pro Plus and transition from device-based to user-based licensing for the same price they are paying for their SA today. Let's take a little closer look at Project 2013 and Visio 2013, now available as user-based services through Office 365. With this release of Office, customers now have the option to move from device-based to user-based licensing for Project Pro by transitioning to Project Pro for Office 365. And instead of implementing an on-premises project server deployment, customers can move to Project Online or to the bundled Project Online and Project Pro for Office 365. Here we see the features of Microsoft's project management tools. Project is available in Standard, Professional, and Project Server Cal on-premises or a service online as Project Pro for Office 365. Project Online or Project Online with Project Pro for Office 365. EA customers with Project Pro with Software Assurance and Project CALS with SA can transition to Project Pro for Office 365 and Project Online. With the transition, the customer stops paying for their local license and SA or SA only and begins paying instead for the online version, allowing customers to easily move from a traditional device-based approach to an online approach. All Visio Premium 2010 capabilities have been moved into Visio Professional 2013. Visio Pro for Office 365 offers the same capabilities as Visio Pro 2013, but is licensed per user. Visio Professional for Office 365 is delivered to the user's PC using click-to-run technology, and EA customers licensed with Visio Pro can transition to Visio Professional for Office 365, moving from device to user-based licensing. Customers can implement Visio Standard 2013, Visio Pro 2013, or Visio Pro for Office 365 in a virtual desktop infrastructure. However, if customers want to use a terminal server or email desktop server, they should implement Visio Standard or Professional 2013. Now let's take a look at Office 2013 servers. With Exchange Server 2013, external connectors have been discontinued and equivalent rights have been added to the server license. Forefront Online Protection for Exchange, or FOPI, is replaced with Exchange Online Protection, or EOP, for reliable online protection against viruses and spam for a customer's on-premises Exchange servers. With Office 2013, we are consolidating our SharePoint portfolio. Search Server merges with SharePoint Server, and Fast Search Server capabilities are now included in SharePoint Server 2013. For external users with 2013, SharePoint CALs are no longer needed, eliminating the need for SharePoint Server for internet sites. So Search, Fast, and SharePoint servers for internet sites are all wrapped up into SharePoint Server 2013. With 2013, the distinction between Link Enterprise and Link Standard disappears, and Link Server 2013 has more capabilities than the previous Enterprise edition. Link for external users will be complementary with the 2013 version. Link external connectors will no longer be available. CALs, or client access licenses, are required for users or devices accessing most Microsoft server software. Let's take a look at server CALs and CAL suites. Customers can easily choose between user or device CALs based on a couple of factors. For customers with fewer devices than users, the device CAL option is ideal and preferred by 40% of customers. For customers with fewer users than devices, the user CAL is a better option and is preferred by 60% of our customers. With the proliferation of devices today, many customers find it easier to simply count users. Client access license suites are the most cost-effective way to maximize your investment in Microsoft technologies. Here we see the components of the core CAL suite and the additional components added to make up the eCAL, or Enterprise CAL suite, such as Active Directory, RMS, System Center Client Management Suite, and the newly added Exchange Online Archiving. With Office 2013, Forefront Protection Suite and Forefront United Access Gateway are removed from the eCAL, but Exchange Enterprise CAL with services include Enterprise Online Protection, or EOP. Effective December 1st of 2012, the user CAL price increased to meet a significant increase in the number of devices that today's users are accessing. There was no change to the device CAL prices. Here we see both the programs and the specific user CALs affected by the user CAL price increase. Notice that SPLA, Academic, and Charity will not be experiencing a CAL price increase. Now let's review migrations with software assurance and transitions. Here we see the current products and the new products that software assurance customers will migrate to. Business Contact Manager, or BCM, for Microsoft Outlook will be available as a free download, and customers with Outlook with BCM and SA will be migrated to Office 2013. Customers with SharePoint Workspace with SA can access the same functionalities through SkyDrive Pro. Customers with Visio Premium with SA will receive the rights to use Visio Pro 2013. Link Server Standard and Enterprise with SA customers migrate to Link Server 2013, which includes all enterprise capabilities but does not require external connector licenses. Customers with Link Server external connectors with SA receive one Link Server 2013 server license. Customer with Exchange Server external connector licenses receive one Exchange Server Enterprise 2013 license per qualifying external connector license. Search server transitions to SharePoint server, and customers with SA on these licenses will be granted one SharePoint server license plus 100 SharePoint 2013 standard CALs. Fast capabilities are available in SharePoint Server 2013. For each Fast Search server license with SA, customers will be granted one SharePoint server license. Customers with SharePoint Server for Internet sites with SA will be awarded one SharePoint Server 2013 license for each SharePoint server for Internet sites. Now let's look at the Enterprise Agreement in Office 365. The Enterprise Agreement provides two ways for customers to easily acquire Office 365 cloud services with an existing Enterprise Agreement through Office 365 transitions and now through Office 365 add-ons. These provide Enterprise Agreement customers with a simple, low-cost way to add Office 365 services to their existing agreements at any time during the agreement term and still maintain the integrity of the Enterprise Agreement and all of their SA benefits. What this means is that EA customers can now move back and forth between the cloud and on-premises office with less effort than ever before. The Enterprise programs for mid-size and large organizations with 250 or more desktop PCs offer a 3-year enrollment term. The EA provides perpetual licenses and the ability to purchase licenses as needed. Software assurance is included, and an organization-wide commitment to the Enterprise desktop enrollment is required. Annual payments are standard, and an annual reconciliation process called true-up is required to account for any devices or users that were added since the last anniversary. Enterprise subscription is for organizations that prefer to subscribe to rather than purchase Microsoft products and provides an initial cost based on a 3-year subscription with the ability to increase or decrease subscription counts on an annual basis. This option may be suitable for customers that expect significant fluctuations in workforce size and IT requirements. Enterprise subscription offers full software assurance benefits. The option to add Office 365 to an EA is available for both direct and indirect customers as additional products to their existing agreement, and the subscription is coterminous with the original agreement, and customers are billed through their existing EA. There is no subscription minimum. Device CALs are eligible for step-up to a user license, which is most advantageous. Now let's look at some of the transition details. Previously, customers were required to use an amendment to add an online service to an existing enterprise agreement. But with the updated version of the agreement, customers can now easily add an online service such as Office 365 or Windows Intune to an existing agreement and satisfy the required enterprise-wide commitment. As we take a look at licensing of transitions, it's important to understand that transitions are the optimal long-term licensing choice for customers that are committed to Office 365 services. There are some licensing changes to accommodate the per-user license of Office 365 services, meaning that to transition the CAL Suite and Office Pro Plus to the cloud, the transition would be to the Office 365 user license plus the Bridge CAL. Since Office 365 is only licensed per user, customers must true up their Bridge CALs and Windows as outlined in their EA transition rules. Another important point to take note of is that Office 365 user licenses are enterprise online services and, as such, do satisfy the underlying EA requirements. Unlike the Office 365 add-ons, which are additional products and do not satisfy the requirement. Notice also that any qualified devices utilized by those with Office 365 user license do not need the Office Pro Plus or CoreCal or eCal suite licenses, but BridgeCals are required when licensing Cal suites per device. And finally, Office 365 USL licenses qualify each licensed user for Office 365 services on both qualified and non-qualified devices on up to 5 devices total. Now, transitions provide true per-user licensing because a customer transitions their current licenses, for example, like Office Pro Plus and Cal Suites, to a full Office 365 user subscription license, or USL, and corresponding BridgeCal. Transitions are optimal for customers that do not need to maintain on-premises licenses, and also for customers who have more qualified devices than users, because the user licensing may reduce true-up costs. The minimum purchase criteria of $250 must be met for customers purchasing on-premise enterprise products, hybrid or combination of enterprise products and enterprise online services, and enterprise online services. With regard to the enterprise-wide commitment, with the enterprise enrollment, quantities of enterprise products purchased must meet qualified device or user count. And with a hybrid enrollment, simply add the quantities of enterprise products and enterprise online services to ensure the customer is licensed fully by either device or by user count. Now let's take a look at Office 365 add-on details. Office 365 add-on provides the easiest way for customers to add Office 365 cloud services. I say this because the underlying enterprise agreement does not change, making administration easy. And since licensing does not change, customers continue to license all of their qualified users or devices in accordance with the existing EA and continue to maintain all of their software assurance benefits, such as new version rights, training, and all those things. It's important to understand that since the Office 365 add-ons are additional products, they do not satisfy the underlying EA requirements, and customers must continue to true up all new qualified users or devices as outlined in their EA. Add-ons are licensed per user on non-qualified devices and on qualified devices that are already licensed under the customer's existing EA on up to a total of 5 devices. Add-ons are simple to transact and allow customers to maintain their SA benefits. And while they do not provide true pure user licensing, meaning customers must continue to true up all their new qualified users and devices per their underlying EA rules, add-ons are optimal for new cloud customers since they are easy to transact and customers can maintain their on-premises licensing. Add-ons have been priced so that the total cost to customers would be nearly equivalent to that of a transition. The add-on versus transition decision should be made based on the licensing implications and customers' objectives. Now let's look at deploying Office 365. Office 365 Fast Track was developed in direct response to customer feedback and was designed to significantly shorten the time to value period so that customers can quickly experience their new cloud environment. Fast Track also vastly improves customer satisfaction of their Office 365 deployment. While the Office 365 onboarding process and steps, customers can experience the value of the services early in the sales cycle and smoothly advance through pilot and deployment. Here's how it works. Customers pilot the service early and quickly and are able to experience the service in a matter of hours. Customers easily move from pilot to deployment within days. Customers then add features on their own terms and are ready in weeks. With Fast Track, some customers can have the entire process completed in as little as 1 to 2 months. So moving to the cloud has never been easier. Now let's take a look at some customer scenarios and transitions. The customer in this scenario has 8,000 enterprise desktop licenses. During year one, the customer provisions 200 Exchange Online P1 full user licenses. And while invoicing can be deferred through license reservation, this customer elects to be invoiced immediately. The first invoice for Exchange Online will only be for the number of months remaining in the first year. At the beginning of year two, the customer is invoiced for 8,000 enterprise desktop licenses and the 200 Exchange Online P1 full USL licenses, and again in year three for the same. In this scenario, the customer has 1,400 Office Pro Plus with SA licenses. In year one, the customer moves 50 users to Office 365 Pro Plus. There is no charge to the customer during the transition period, and the customer is invoiced at the beginning of year two for the 50 Office 365 Pro Plus users and the 1,350 Office Pro Plus with SA licenses. At the end of year two, the customer moves 450 more users to Office 365 Pro Plus. At the beginning of year three, the customer is invoiced for a total of 500 Office 365 Pro Plus licenses and 900 Office Pro Plus with SA licenses. During year three, the customer moves the 900 remaining users to Office 365 Pro Plus. At renewal, the customer renews 1,400 Office 365 Pro Plus licenses, and there is no charge for the transition of the 900 users. Perpetual use rights are determined each time he transitions to an online service. For example, if Office 2010 was the current version, then the first 50 users were transitioned. The customer would have had 50 perpetual Office Professional Plus 2010 licenses. In this scenario, the customer is transitioning from Pro Desktop to Office 365 Enterprise E3, and they start out with 8,000 Pro Desktop with SA licenses. During year one, the customer transitions 2,000 Office Pro Plus with SA plus Core Cals with SA to 2,000 Plan E3. There is no charge for the transition during this period. At the beginning of year two, the customer is invoiced for 6,000 Office Pro Plus with SA, 6,000 Core Cals with SA, 8,000 Windows operating systems with SA licenses, 2,000 Office 365 Plan E3s, and 2,000 Core Cal bridge SKUs for Office 365. During year two, the customer adds 3,000 K2 for previously uncovered manufacturing floor workers and is immediately invoiced for those. Notice that kiosk plans can never be used for transitions and are always treated as additional products, so they cannot be used for meeting a customer's enterprise-wide commitment. At the beginning of year three, the customer is invoiced for 6,000 Office Pro Plus with SA, 6,000 Core Cal with SA, 8,000 Windows operating systems with SA, 2,000 Office 365 Plan E3s, 2,000 Core Cal bridge SKUs for Office 365, and 3,000 Office 365 Plan K2s. The first invoice for kiosk licenses is for the remaining number of months in the second year, and the second invoice is for the 12 months going forward. In this scenario, the customer has a per device EA with 1,000 qualified devices and 1,000 qualified users. The devices are licensed for the Core Cal suite. During year one, the customer decides to add Office 365 Plan E1 for 100 users. So they order 100 Office 365 E1 add-ons to Core Cal licenses, which are invoiced at the time they are added. Note, the customer can complete the transaction in two ways, via a purchase order at time Office 365 is added, or via the licensing reservation process with add-ons billed in arrears at anniversary. At the year one anniversary, they are invoiced for software assurance for 1,000 CoreCal suite licenses per the standard EA billing, and they continue to cover the 100 users for Office 365, so they are also invoiced for the annual cost for the 100 Office 365 add-ons to CoreCal licenses. They continue with the same configuration in year two, so their year two anniversary invoice is exactly the same as the year one anniversary invoice. Our key takeaways here are that add-ons are additional products and can be purchased at any time, and there is no minimum commitment. Secondly, qualifying licenses like the CoreCal and Office are required on the EA to purchase add-ons. In this scenario, the customer has a per-device EA with 1,000 qualified devices and 1,000 qualified users. The devices are licensed for the professional desktop, which includes Windows upgrades, Office Professional Plus, and CoreCal Suite. During year one, the customer decides to add Office 365 Plan E3 for 100 users. So they order 100 Office 365 E1 add-ons to CoreCal and Office licenses, which are invoiced at the time they are added. Note that the customer can complete the transaction again in two ways, via that purchase order that we discussed earlier when Office 365 is added, or via that license reservation and add-ons again are billed in arrears at anniversary. At the year one anniversary, they are invoiced for software assurance for the 1,000 professional desktop licenses per the standard EA billing, and they continue to cover the 100 users for Office 365. So they are also invoiced for the annual cost for the 100 Office 365 E3 add-ons to CoreCal and Office licenses. The add-on licenses provide the flexibility to remove users at their anniversary, and the customer determines that only half of the users are taking advantage of Office 365 benefits, and they decide to remove 50 users at their year two anniversary. So for the year two anniversary, they are invoiced for SA for the 1,000 professional desktop licenses and just 50 Office 365 E3 and add-ons to CoreCal and Office licenses. Our key takeaways from this slide are, number one, that add-ons are additional products under the EA, and they can be purchased at any time and have no minimum commitment. And again, qualifying licenses like the CoreCal or Office are required on the EA to purchase those add-ons. And also, most importantly, customers may discontinue add-ons, but they can only do that at anniversary. In this scenario, the customer has a per-device EA with 1,000 qualified devices and 1,000 qualified users. The devices are licensed for the professional desktop, which includes Windows upgrades, Office Professional Plus, and CoreCal Suite. During year one, the customer decides to transition 100 users from Office Professional Plus on-premises to Office 365 Plan E3. So they order 100 Office 365 E3 transition SKUs. These special SKUs allow customers to make the transition mid-year at no cost and then begin paying the Office 365 user subscription licenses at their next anniversary. At the year one anniversary, they are then invoiced for the 100 Office 365 E3 user subscription licenses. They now have 900 devices remaining for which they need to pay for software assurance for Office Professional Plus and CoreCal Suite, but they do not have to keep paying for SA on the 100 that were transitioned to Office 365. To cover the CoreCal Suite for the 100 users now on Office 365 E3, they pay for SA for 100 CoreCal Bridge for Office 365. All 1,000 devices are still licensed for Windows upgrades, so they are invoiced for Windows SA on the 1,000 qualified devices. They continue with the same configuration year two, so their year two anniversary invoice remains exactly the same. And again, the key takeaways from this slide is that transitions help users move from on-premises software licenses to online service subscriptions. And also, you stop paying for SA for on-premises Office workloads licenses and begin paying for Office 365 user subscription licenses. Now that you've completed the Office 2013 and Office 365 course, take the associated assessment to test your knowledge. Again, I want to thank you for your time and attention during this course, and bye for now.